New this morning, in just the past half hour, President Trump hinting he's planning to take executive action on health care. The president tweeting, quote, "Since Congress can't get its act together on health care, I will be using the power of the pen to give great health care to many people fast." You'll recall Senate Republicans tried multiple times to repeal and replace President Obama's health care law, but failed to get enough votes.
Developing here at home, 694 in Brooklyn Center is back open this morning after a deadly crash between a semi and an ambulance. It happened at the eastbound 694-94 split around 7 o'clock last night, closing the road for about 4 hours. This morning, we know the passenger in that ambulance, a 24-year-old paramedic, was killed in that crash.
And there are still questions about how this all happened as investigators tried to reconstruct that crash. Ellery McArdle joining us now with the latest on the investigation.
Well, guys, the question being asked this morning is, was that ambulance driver impaired? The Minnesota State Patrol doesn't believe so, but it's all part of its investigation to try and figure out why this crash happened. If you look at the front of the ambulance, you can see it is crunched. State Patrol says the ambulance was merging near the 694-94 split when it hit the back of a semi. That semi was already stopped for mechanical issues. The ambulance driver was taken to North Memorial and is expected to be okay. There were no patients inside of the ambulance at the time. State Patrol also tells us the paramedics were driving from Monticello to the Riverside neighborhood in Minneapolis. Alicia?
All right, Ellery, thank you. New overnight, Minneapolis police investigating a late night shooting. Police say it happened just before 11 last night in the 2400 block of Ogema Place. Officers arriving to find one person with a gunshot wound to the head. The victim was transported to the hospital in critical condition.
Also developing this morning, a 19-year-old Texas Tech student is in custody suspected of killing a university police officer at the campus police headquarters. The university says it happened when the student was being questioned about evidence of drugs and drug paraphernalia found in his dorm room. That's when police say the 19-year-old pulled out a gun, shot the officer in the head, killing him. The student then fled on foot, only to be captured later. New overnight, more than 100 missing person reports from the raging wildfires burning across California that have killed at least 10 confirmed people. At least another 100 are injured, and at least 1,500 homes and businesses have been destroyed. All those figures are expected to surge as new information is released in the coming days.
Meanwhile, rescues there continuing this morning as those flames continue to threaten new areas. Melissa Colorado, she's in the newsroom tracking the devastating fires. Melissa.
Well, Tim and Alicia, tens of thousands of acres in northern and southern California are on fire this morning. The flames are pushed by warm winds and fueled by dry ground. And despite thousands of firefighters on the ground, the state's governor says it is not under control by any means. And Governor Jerry Brown has declared an emergency in 8 counties, including Napa and Sonoma, the heart of California's wine country. Officials expect the death toll, currently at 10 people, to rise. More than 100 people have been reported missing in Northern California, and hundreds of homes have been scorched by the flames. And officials are urging residents not to return yet because some fires are reigniting.
My front porch is on fire, but seeing what happened over here and the destruction and the devastation just makes me so upset. And I pray that these people will be okay.
Moving to Southern California, thousands of people have been forced to evacuate from their homes in the city of Anaheim, home to Disneyland. 6,000 acres are on fire. Only 5% of the fire in Southern California has been contained. And the National Weather Service warns that weather conditions will still pose a threat this morning. The good news, however, winds are expected to weaken later today and into tomorrow. And that's, of course, firefighters need all the help they can get from Mother Nature right now, guys.
Most definitely. All right, Melissa, thank you.
Well, several Minnesota natives have wineries in Sonoma and Napa counties. Bill Spell from Edina says his winery in Santa Rosa is safe, but that the fire destroyed homes within 2 blocks of it. The power at the winery is out, and all the employees have been evacuated. There have been at least 2 other wineries destroyed and several others damaged.
We're in contact with our people by cell phone, but it's very scary because these things are very dangerous.
The wildfires came as Napa and Sonoma counties were finishing highly anticipated harvests of wine grapes. Normally this week, workers would be picking and processing the ripe grapes to make Chardonnay and other wines. Here in Minnesota, the state fire marshal is investigating what caused a restaurant and bar to go up in flames early yesterday morning. Firefighters were called out to about 3 a.m. to Johnny Ringo's in Spring Valley. Before fire crews arrived, sheriff's deputies worked to evacuate nearby apartments, including those who lived above the restaurant. Locals say the building, which dates back to the 1800s, is a total loss.
Well, after spending most of the week in the ICU, a Minnesota native injured in the Las Vegas mass shooting is out of intensive care. 36-year-old Phil Orrick was shot in the back as he and his girlfriend were running away from the mass shooting scene last week. He had to undergo two operations. Over the weekend, he was moved to a step-down unit and was able to see his two children for the first time since the shooting.
He held it together good. He was able to keep his voice even, and of course he's exhausted and it hurts to use any muscle, but it went really well, and I think they left knowing that he's still there, like normal dad.
That's the good news there. His family is thanking everyone for their support. They say he is making leaps and bounds every day. An Arizona man has a new truck after helping rescue victims during the Las Vegas attack. During the shooting, Marine veteran Taylor Winston and others stole a truck and drove several people to nearby hospitals. The owner of an auto shop says he was so overwhelmed by the brave stories he heard about Winston that he presented him with a free truck yesterday. Winston has said he was just operating on instinct.